Wait, how's it going, guys? Sorry about my hair. I was driving with my top down. My throat gurgled. Weird. Anyway, I was gonna be like, since we're not doing Life of Lizzie, let's do shit show cooking. And I was like, I don't feel like cooking. So I went in the frozen section. And, I'm sad about my body, and I'm sad that I'm going backwards with eating disorders, so I decided I'm not eating healthy. I'm not working out at all this weekend. And I'm not gonna feel guilty about anything I eat for the next 2 days. I'm just gonna be a kid again. I'm gonna eat what I wanna eat, and I'm not gonna worry about it. And, Sunday when I go back to work, I'm just gonna eat regular healthy meals, and I'm done dieting because I just can't. So can't do it. It's bad for me. So this year, my birthday challenge is not going to be a fitness one. Although I still am eating healthy, I'm not gonna let myself go. I made a shit ton of progress. I lost 60 pounds. I'm not losing momentum. I'm not counting calories. I'm not going to do any extra workouts other than go to work. Come home, focus on my YouTube channel, focus on what I'm doing for my birthday challenge, and just stop caring about what the fuck my weight is, what I look like, what I can and can't fit into, what I can and can't do with my body anymore. I'm just fucking done. I can't think about it for one more second. So, I was like, one, I need pizza because anytime I'm a New Yorker, anytime I celebrate, it's where's the pizza? If I'm sad, pizza. If I'm happy, pizza. Just fucking pizza. So I'm like, I don't want the huge. Like, I want new pizza. I want pizza that's gonna just say fuck it with me. Just like one of them pizzas that's just so, like, you can feel your arteries clogging, but you're just at the same time, it's so fucking good. Cheese, cheese everywhere, cheese. So, DiGiorno's been my thing lately. Out of all the frozen pizzas, I stick with Red Baron and DiGiorno as a New Yorker. Those are the only fucking ones I will touch. The other ones are garbage. How dare you call that pizza? Ew! Don't fuck with no pizza. I'm from New York. I will get pissed if you fuck up pizza. Not like enough to say anything, but I'll be like, I'll take a bite and I'll just be shaking my head at you like, I miss my home. Every time I eat bad pizza, I get homesick. I want to go home. This is not pizza. Hashtag every New Yorker everywhere. Or a hot dog. Fuck is this? This ain't a hot dog. Oh my god, I want to go home because right now I just really want a hot dog and these people don't know what the fuck a hot dog is. Oh, so true for New Yorkers. Am I right? Am I right? That's true for anyone who has like something that's home-based. Everybody's known for something, or whatever your thing is. But anyway, next weekend I am gonna do a shit show cooking because I'm gonna teach you specific to Syracuse salt potatoes. Nobody's ever heard of it outside of Syracuse. Everyone thinks it's fucking gross until we make you eat it, and then you're like, why did I eat potatoes any other way? This is bullshit. How did I not know about this? So, I might do it tomorrow. I might grab a bag because now that I'm talking about it, I really want some, and that's my rule. If I want it, I eat it in the next 2 days. So guess what we're doing tomorrow? I was looking for also specific to our area Hoffman hot dogs. That's why. Like, not even New York City has Hoffman's all the time. They do sometimes we do ship there, but they are made specifically in this region, and they're the most delicious fucking hot dog. So much so that they used to have a chain of restaurants. They went out because nobody cares about hot dogs anymore. You know, outside of the city. I've got mostly fat from hot dogs. Hoffman hot dogs, for real. Like, it's something about the skin, I don't know. If you don't eat meat, it isn't gonna be your thing. They don't do fake ones, because for meat eaters, okay, I'm sorry. We like our meat around here. I do. I like the meat. Some people prefer tacos. I don't judge. I like taco food, though. Not the, like, you know, I'll eat a taco, but not like the body taco, okay? But like the real, like, out of the box, Ortega, I'll eat that kind of taco all day. Seconds, too. We're gonna do tacos on Shit Show Cooking, too. So this summer, I'm gonna do Hoffman hot dogs and salt potatoes for Shit Show Cooking. I'm going to do maybe a homemade pizza. I'm going to do all my favorites. Just my favorite stuff that's bad for you. Like, you're going to be my cheat day foods. But I'm going to slip in some healthy stuff too. Anyway. The pizza I picked out after 25 minutes almost of just... I've never been to a store. I don't normally go to the store. I go there for these. It's Tops, by the way. The one near me. I don't know if all Tops do this. But they're the only place I can get tie-dye fucking bagels. They're just plain bagels. They didn't have any tie-dye ones left, but they had the red, white, and blue ones. So I got one for breakfast tomorrow and one for breakfast the next day because I only had two in there. They're plain. You know, it doesn't make it taste any different. I just like it. It's cool. I drive up the extra little bit just to get those. And now I'm going there for pizza because they literally, the only store that has like a whole wall of all, like I've never seen so many choices. I'm going to be playing. Tonight I am making, alright Detroit, don't fuck up my pizza. But I was just looking at it, I was like, everybody goes on about this. You know, Chicago deep dish, but I never heard of Detroit style crust. Crispy and caramelized. I'm a little scared, but I never had a Detroit pizza, so I was like, and it's new, see? New. It's fresh out the company box, too. So, I'm trying it. My oven is preheated. This is Shit Show Fake Cooking, because I don't feel like fucking cooking, bro. And instead of ordering pizza and waiting an hour, and it being cold and like $40. Look, I'm from back in the day. My parents used to leave $20 on the table. That used to get us pizza, breadsticks, and wings. For all five of us kids. What the fuck, America? You know, you can make five pizzas at home cheaper for ordering. Oh, it comes with its own dish. How clever, Detroit. Maybe I should read the directions. Because I don't know what. I ain't never seen no pizza cooked in no dish like lasagna. I'm scared. Don't fuck up my pizza, Detroit. Alright, let's see. I'm sure it's good. It wouldn't make it if it wasn't good. I'm being optimistic, but that's weird. Do you cook your pizza like this, Detroit? Are they being authentic? Because ours are circle and flat. Like, our pizza pans are circle and flat. Are yours square? What the fuck, Detroit? I'm gonna go find out. I'm gonna go sit in the pizza shop. Like, what are you doing? It's not how you make pizza. I am an expert from New York. Thank you. We are the inventors of pizza. Sit down, Detroit. Just kidding. I don't actually know who invented pizza, but I feel like that's what New York's known for. Pizza and hot dogs. But I am also a scientist, and I like ingenious ideas. Chicago did a damn good job with their deep dish. What is this caramelized shit? I don't get it. What is it caramelized in? What am I eating? Detroit, are you comfortable with just putting stuff in your mouth that you just don't know? You better watch out. I'm from Detroit. And like, this bitch wrote talk shit about our pizza in his room. All right. Oh. Holy shit, I didn't know Nestle made DiGiorno. Like Nestle? Like Nestle milk stuff? Whoa! You learn stuff every day. Read the directions. God damn it. Preheated. Did that. ADD so bad. Sweat shit show cooking. What was I doing? Oh yeah. Oh god. I need supervision. Remove film from pan. Okay. Well, that makes sense, because I don't want plastic in my pizza. Hi! Thank you. This is too much work, Detroit. What the fuck is wrong? Why do you work so hard, Detroit? You know, there's easier ways to do this. All the cheese go in the corners. Like, this was not supposed to be work, Detroit. I should stop saying Detroit and say DiGiorno. It's not Detroit's fault. They didn't vote for this. They did not cast their vote. They did not vote yes, stay on the island. Thank you, Luna. I was just about to yell at you. I do not like them up here at all. But when I'm cooking, I will fucking spray them in the face. I'm not cat hair in our food. Thank you. They know. Don't fuck with me when I'm cooking. Okay. Hold on. I must wash my hands. Let me pausey. Wait, I can't. I'll talk to you. Don't judge my messy kitchen. It's kind of messy. You can't see it, but there's crumbs on my stove. And that, to me, drives me fucking nuts. I'm a Virgo. I hate doing dishes so much that all are left are my pans. And they can't put in the dishwasher and I have to wash them while this is cooking. See? It's a fancy one. I was like, no, I don't want to do it yet. I'm going to go to the store first. I'm just going to let them soak. Alright, let's spin it. Film off. Place pan directly on center oven rack. Okay. Center rack, that's top. Get it self. And center rack, boom. Bake 22 minutes. Timer. I use my microwave as my cooking timer because it has a timer built into it. No more of those windy things anymore. If you're old like me, you know what I'm talking about. It was usually like an apple or a tomato. And then like you just spun the top and it would tick, 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 tick. Enjoy. For best results, remove pan from oven by placing onto a heat-resistant cutting board or baking sheet. Let stand 3 to 5. Wait. Oh, that's after cooking. I was like, what? I'm supposed to remove it? 3 to 5 minutes. So when this bitch comes out, I gotta take it out. Let it sit. That's norm. Nothing too complicated so far to try it. It's just a little weird shaped. I can get over that, though. Some people here, there's a restaurant that cuts their pizza the long way. And at first, everybody hated it. They're called Twin Trees, but their pizza is so fucking good that, like, you know the pizza by the cut. They not only made a delicious pizza everybody wants, but they have their own specific cut. So, we don't get hung up on shapes now, because that shit knocked us out of the park I don't know what they put in that sauce and that cheese, but at first we were like, because instead of like cutting it in triangles, they were cutting it in long strips, like long skinny strips. And we're New Yorkers, we fold our motherfucking pizza. Eat that shit. I don't really like, I only like the big pieces like that, but there's a difference. This is what you don't know about New York. When you go to a place and you're just buying slices, like I just want a slice of cheese, they're going to give you the giant slice that you fold. If you buy a whole pizza pie, your pizza is normal. You don't have to fold it. So in New York, you can get pizza just like home. You just have to order a full pie. We do everything big in New York. It's the Big Apple. So our slices are huge. That's what sets us apart, the folding of the pizza. But what you also don't know, as a New Yorker, we take a napkin, any of us that are health conscious people, or just don't want it to drip all over us. There's a ton of grease on your pizza. So I take my pizza and I hold it up and I crank it a little so it's not a full fold, but all of the grease is kind of pooling down, and I let it collect on the napkin. And sometimes, if the napkin's not too cheap, I'll actually dab the grease right off the top of the pizza just because that's less than I'm ingesting and less getting on your body. That's definitely a New York thing. If you're born and raised here, you know that once you get pizza grease on your shirt, that shirt is fucking done for life. You can never get pizza grease off of it. You could wash that shit a million times, it's still gonna be there. You will literally ruin your clothes. We know how to fucking eat a pizza without getting it all. I get it on my face just because I have a little mouth. So even with the folding, like I'll get sauce here. I don't care. I'll just do this like a kid. I'm so good. That's a New Yorker. Like, we'll get messy if it's good. Tacos are messy. Hot dogs are messy. Pizza is messy. But that motherfucking shit, when you eat it, you're just like, That's usually our lunch foods. We don't usually eat that shit for dinner. That's like usually we have a long ass work day. We need some fucking energy. We're hungover from work. We need some greasy fucking shit. Like, we gotta go work. We're hungover from the night before. I mean, nothing cures you better than a greasy ass pizza or a fucking hot dog on your way. Just street vendors like, hey, like shit, I need a hot dog. Load it up, bro. And you're gonna feel like shit for a second, but then that grease soaks up all that shit. Like, there's no. We don't have time for hangovers. We don't have time for things during the day. So that's why we have a million street food vendors. Why everything we can eat with our hands. It's right. On the go. That's a little fun fact pizza trivia for you. I only like cheese pizza. I'm a weirdo. Well, not only. I eat chicken bacon ranch pizza. I tried fajita steak pizza, but I picked the peppers off because I don't like peppers. I'm like a 6-year-old child. I just pick shit right off my food. I'm like, you'll just see a stack on my plate. Like, I've done that my whole life. I'm just so weird. I'm weird. I'm an alien. I don't like it. I'm not eating it. If I don't like the texture, pfft. If I don't like the taste, pfft. If I don't like how it looks, I'm not even gonna try it. I am not brave with food because in my past lives I was royalty, and I can't tell you how many times I died because people put shit in my food. So I have a whole thing about it. I just don't do it. Don't judge me, okay? Don't judge me. People are scandalous motherfuckers. And it always came from my siblings, or my parents, or my uncles, or my aunts. I was like, this bitch took me out. I'm just eating this delicious little fucking fruit tart, and then I'm like, on the ground. Like, I'm fucking my food. If the restaurant is sketch, well, no, because I've eaten some shack places. The food's good. I don't give a fuck about the atmosphere. If people go there a lot and they frequent it and they don't die, I'll be like, But if it's like you're just like on a road trip and you pull up to that place and you're like, oh no, I feel like there's gonna be a roach in my sandwich. I'm not doing it. I don't wanna roll the dice with food poisoning. Have you ever seen Bridesmaids? Do you wanna shit in the sink? No, thank you. No, thank you. I don't fuck around with food. But anyway, like I said, I also got. They don't sell just one, so now I guess I'm gonna have to eat one tonight and tomorrow. Oh shit, Cinnabons. See, this is why you shouldn't just make stuff for couples. They're single people, and now I'm gonna eat both when I could have just got one. I'm not sad about eating both. Don't get it twisted. But you know, cinnamon buns are like 5,000 calories. So stop it. See? I hate this eating disorder. I'm supposed to just eat what I want without thinking about it. And right now, I'm thinking about all the bad shit. Anyway, for my dessert tonight. Well, actually, no, I think I forgot I got those. These will be my desserts in the week. I got this. When I come home from work, I'll celebrate with this $1 cup of love to myself. Do you remember Friendly's, the restaurant? I think there's one left around here. I fucking love going there as a kid with the Conehead sundae. They had the best hot dog. I just love going there. Can we go to Friendly's, Mom? My mom could afford it. I love that place. But now they make stuff in the store, so I buy it just to remember my childhood. Like on my birthday, do you know how many birthday ice cream sundaes I got with the cone head on top, with the whipped cream hair? They used to put this would be this ice cream. It's just ice cream cake with the frosting and everything. It's a piece of ice cream cake in this cup, but their version of ice cream cake. I also got a Reese's peanut butter cup one because I couldn't pick. So for 2 days this week, I'll get a treat to myself. Whatever, I don't care. This was me in the store. I want it? Okay. That looks good? Okay. But now, on the way home, I'm like, I did not buy anything healthy. Like, not one thing. I'm not supposed to be thinking about that. Like, stop it! Just let me enjoy my 2 days of fuck offness. So, those two is 10,000 calories. I do 10,000 calories worth of work in my work day, so. You know? Burn it off. Anyway, I also bought this because this is my favorite Parmesan cheese, and no store carries it. They're all starting to carry their brands, which I don't fucking like. They don't make it like Kraft. Like, I want Kraft. Excuse me. Can you put yourself back in more stores? So when I find it in a store, I don't just buy the like normal size. I buy the mega hefty, hefty, hefty. 'Cause this is what I put on top of my chicken rice. You sprinkle it and then eat, and then I sprinkle some more when it's gone, and I eat the next layer. And I sprinkle some, like, you know, don't fuck with my Parmesan cheese. Wegmans is the only one that I can tolerate, but even then, it has to be the Parmesan Romano one, not the regular one. It's like gritty. I don't know what Kraft does, but it's so fine grained and perfectly just delicious. You know? Kraft, what the fuck? They're stealing your Parmesan cheese spots. And whatever happened, Prego, to your cheese sauce? Not your Alfredo white sauce, not like your macaroni and cheese sauce. You had a cheese. Regular cheddar sauce. I used to buy it by the dozen, and so did everybody else. We used to literally fight for it off the shelf because we Love that shit on our cheese fries, on our hot dogs. You made the best fucking cheese, and then all of a sudden, without any warning, it disappeared off of any shelf. I can't even order it on Amazon. What the fuck, Prego? I don't even have a can to show you. And I'm angry at you because now you have ruined every cheese. I don't even try to buy any other cheese because it's not gonna be good. Like, I haven't had a cheese dog since you. I've had cheese fries, yes. But I have to order them. I can't make them at home. Like, I wore my dance shoes. I just stuck to the floor. I have a sticker on my shoe. I still picked up a little kid's sticker on my way in. Anyway, I need to show you when the pizza's done. I'll pause it. How many more minutes? 10 minutes. You don't need to. You've seen a cooked pizza. This is what we're doing. I'm just gonna cut it when it comes out and eat it. Surprise! But I'm sure it's delicious. If it isn't, I'll put below in the comments. Ew! Then you'll know it wasn't good. But it's already smelling good, so. You, like, really have to do a bad job to fuck up a cheese pizza. Like, you can fuck up flavors. You can, like, fuck up by putting too much of something on. But I don't think you can fuck up by putting too much cheese on it. Just, my opinion, you don't fucking put enough. Like, load me up, bro. I love cheese. I love cheese! Anyway. Back girl out. See you next time. Toodaloo. No, that's mean. We're not talking mean to ourselves either. All these words I say to myself. You're so fat. Stop it. It's subliminally putting myself down. Even though I know I'm joking, my mind is like, we're fat? What? So I can't. So, redo, because I don't like to edit. This is me editing. Over and out. Bye. Love you. Toodles.